Hello guys, and it is a beautiful day today. Welcome to another Smock Boy Who review. Also, my other name, welcome to another Smock Boy Who 29 review. I hope everyone is okay. I hope everyone is brilliant. I hope everyone is good. Now, I do have a good announcement to make today in this video, but I will make the announcement after I have done this video. So today, guys, now, as everyone knows, I have Sonic screwdrivers. I also have mainly some of the Dr. Sonic screwdrivers. Now, I thought, why don't I just do my top 10 favourite Sonic screwdrivers? So, basically, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to tell you my top 10 Sonic screwdrivers, going to basically show you the ones that I have seen in the actual series, and also I'm going to show you also, even though you guys already know, I do have the toys of them. The only one, sadly, I will not be showing in this video, the toy version of this in this video, will be the Fourth Doctor's, because sadly I have misplaced it somewhere. I cannot find it anywhere. Hopefully, I should find it in a couple of days, but hopefully I will find it, and then, yeah. But by the time I probably have found it, this video will be over, and I will basically be showing you the rest of the Sonic screwdrivers. So, do you know what, guys? Let's start with who made it to number 10. Let's find out right now. Right, guys, so as you probably saw in the photo, it is the Sixth Doctor's Sonic screwdriver. Well, it's not really called a screwdriver. Well, it's called, do you know what? I don't know the name of it, but I'm going to say the Sixth Doctor Sonic screwdriver. So basically, this one was used that I first saw in the Sixth Doctor's episode in his second season. No, actually, in his first season, actually, proper season, when he faced the Cybermen. And you actually see it being used in that episode. You actually see him use it when the Cyberman episode is on. So you do see that. So Colin Baker's Sonic screwdriver made it to number 10. Let's find out who made it to number 9. So guys, as you probably saw, it was Patrick Troughton's. Now, this is going to be the shocking thing, because that Sonic screwdriver is actually the first ever Sonic screwdriver to ever appear in the actual show. Will I be getting it? Yes, because as you just saw in the photo, it is a toy version of it. I will be getting that, and I will be doing a special video for that Sonic screwdriver. And the really cool thing is as well, I might spice things up a little bit in my videos. I might actually do, when I get the Sonic, I might maybe do it in black and white, just to show you guys in black and white, how it would look in black and white in the video. And then what I'll do is I'll go back to colour, and then literally I will show you the colour of the laser. But anyway, so Patrick Troughton's made it to number 9. Now, the really funny thing is he's made it to number 9 now 3 times in my reviews. But to be honest, it's his Sonic. I've seen it only once, and it was brilliant the way he used it. He used it to actually undo a screw, which was actually quite funny. So he made it to number 9. So let's find out who made it to number 8. Let's go. Number 8 is the great John Pertwee's Sonic screwdriver. Now, this one was used in the first, this Sonic screwdriver actually made the first proper appearance of the Sonic screwdriver. It made its proper first appearance in Inferno, I do believe. If my cousin Gary is watching this, Gary, hope you don't correct me on that, but I bet you probably will. But to be honest, it's cool, because Gary, my cousin Gary, does know more knowledge about Doctor Who than I do, and I'm very happy that Gary can help me with my knowledge of Doctor Who. So let's continue. So basically, John Pertwee's Sonic screwdriver made it to number 8. Let's find out who actually made it to number 7. Let's go. And as you probably all saw, it is the 8th Doctor Sonic screwdriver. Now, it was only used in the movie, I do believe, once. So if anyone can correct me on that, I hopefully they would, and I do appreciate it. So that basically made it to number 7. So basically, I can't really say much on this Sonic Screwdriver because really I have seen it been used once in the movie, which was very good and which was very cool. And that's really it. That's all I have to say, really. Oh, and also it was used in the Knights of the Doctor as well. I do apologise. I actually completely forgot about that. It was used in Knights of the Doctor as well. So let's find out who made it to number 6. Let's go. And number 6 would have to be the great John Hurst's Sonic Screwdriver, the War Doctor Sonic Screwdriver. The first one, I think it's the first one to ever actually use a light, I do believe. I think it is. So John Hurst had the red laser Sonic Screwdriver, which was actually called the War Doctor Sonic Screwdriver, as everyone knows, because he wasn't actually the Doctor. He was actually called the War Doctor. So the War Doctor's Sonic Screwdriver makes it to the number it is, because at the end of the day, it is one I would love to get. I would love to get that Sonic Screwdriver, and I'd love to do a special review. So basically, that's the one. War Doctors. Let's find out who's next. Let's go. Hello, guys, and I do apologise right now, because just previously, I just actually mucked up the video. So don't worry, you're not going to see what part I mucked up anyway, but it's fine, it's cool. Right, so at number 5, now we're coming into my top 5. At number 5, we have the legendary Tom Baker, and he turned 90 on the 20th of January this year. I just want to wish Tom, I know this is going to be a bit late, but Tom, I want to wish you a very happy birthday. I hope you had a good day, and I hope you had a brilliant day. Tom is the legend. I think now in legendary terms, he's a legendary Doctor. His Sonic Screwdriver made it to number 5 because literally it was one of my favourites, and it was used in most of the episodes that I watched, which were Genesis of the Daleks, the Cyberman one, and also I did see it in the last one he was in before he regenerated. But to be honest, Tom is one of my favourite Doctors as well, which he is, which everyone knows. So that's enough about Tom Baker. Sadly, guys, I do have the toy version, as you probably all have seen in my previous Sonic Screwdriver reviews. I do have the toy of the fourth Sonic Screwdriver, but sadly, I have misplaced it. I do not know where it is. Hopefully, I can find it soon. And then, literally, then I will be able to... you'll probably be able to see it in my first actual video when I've done my first ever series of this. So, I hope everyone... I do apologise to everyone who's watching this, I do apologise, but sadly I will not be showing you the fourth toy Sonic Screwdriver. But now, let's find out who made it to number 4. Let's go. And yes, guys, we are back, and number 4 has to be this one. Yes, it belonged to Christopher Eccleston and David Tennant, the 9th and 10th Doctors. Yes, they belonged to them. This was my first ever Sonic Screwdriver that I bought, and then I gave it to a friend of mine at school. And then literally when I got back into Doctor Who last year in 2023, I decided to basically buy my Sonic Screwdrivers again. I decided to buy them, and also I found a couple of them that I actually did have previously in the loft, which was very, very interesting that I actually kept all my Sonics from my previous times. So basically this was the first one I ever bought. But then this is now my second one. So this is my second one I've now bought. So I did have problems with this one, which was the problems. The bottom bit kept coming off, and it was really bad, and it kept annoying me. So I decided to grab some super glue the bottom to it. And I don't know if I did use too much super glue. I probably think I did. But then all of a sudden now I can't get it to go up, which is now the problem. So literally the only thing now I can do is do the bottom button and do that. I can't do it on the top button, I can only do it on the bottom. It does make two different noises, which everyone has previously seen in my previous video. So please, guys, watch my Sonic Screwdriver reviews. Watch my Sonic Screwdriver review video, because it was worth watching. So let's find out who made it to number 3. Let's go. Okay, guys, we are back, and it has to be the 13th Doctor Sonic Screwdriver. Now, the really funny thing is with other previous guys that I've seen do reviews on their favourite Sonic Screwdrivers. So guys, basically, this is also my personal favourite solid screwdrivers. Not the other people's. But basically, they put this lower. And they also mentioned the Fifth Doctor's as well. But sadly, I'm not going to mention the Fifth Doctor's, because literally the Fifth Doctor's is exactly identical to the Fourth Doctor's. But only the difference is between the Fifth and the Fourth is that basically it's got a white ring. That's the only difference. So that's why the Fifth was never mentioned in this video. But anyway, enough about that. Let's talk about the 13th Doctor's. So basically, when she was stranded on Earth after she lost the TARDIS, after regeneration, Jodie Whittaker, after Jodie Whittaker's regeneration, she then made this. She got the costume all done back at home in London, England. Why am I saying it like that for? Like people already know they've watched Doctor Who, they already know how she made the video. So basically what happened was she created this sonic screwdriver. This is one of my favourite toys, I will admit that. Like I just love this sonic. It is one of my favourites. And I'm trying to get it to light up, but it won't light up for me. Oh, there we go, it lights up. But I just like the detail of it as well. I love that. I love the noise it makes as well. And also, it's brilliant as well. And also, there is a guy on Instagram. I will try and find his name for you, and I will leave a link in the description below, because he also has, not one of these, he has two, but he has a different version of it. But I think it's the same version, but what he's done is he's took the LED lights out of this sonic screwdriver and he's made it blue. So when David actually first regenerated, so when Jodie regenerated back into David, this was the first sonic screwdriver that he had. Basically before the previous one that we all loved and saw in the 60th anniversary. So when he had that one, this one became blue. And he actually had a blue crystal in it. And it was absolutely brilliant. I loved it. I asked him how he done it. He basically, I think he took the screwdriver apart. I think that's all he done. I think he just literally took the screwdriver apart and then literally he put blue LED lights in it. And that's all I think he done. But if I do ever myself get another one, I am going to try and do the lights and actually try either make it blue or even make it red, just to see how cool it would be in red. But to be honest, I'd love to do it in blue, because I think the blue version would be brilliant. But anyway, enough about that. Let's find out who made it to number two. Let's go. So guys, at number two, it had to come a joint place, because literally when I was doing my top 10 sonic screwdriver reviews, I actually left Matt out. I so didn't mean to either, because in the video of me telling you about my sonic screwdrivers, basically, the order is now different. So I do apologise for that, guys, but basically now I'm going to do a, not a comparison, but basically I'm actually going to say, like, who now made it to number two. So actually, who made it to number two, and I'm actually proud that I've got these, has to be these two, the 11th and the 12th. So the reason is Matt's sonic screwdriver is in my top two is because literally I like it, because it can do this. That's the only reason why I like it, because literally I think it was the first sonic screwdriver not to ever do, like, because with the fourth, like, you just press it down and it goes do, it makes a noise. That was such a bad impression of a sonic screwdriver, guys. I do apologize, but basically it's just the way it works. I love it. You can pull it down again, and that was it. That was the reason why I liked it. But I bought the 12th version of this sonic screwdriver, and it was the best version I ever bought, really. It was a good version I bought. This was my second one I actually bought myself. Yes. And then my good friend actually bought me the 13th Doctor's. So literally, in that sonic screwdriver review, I did have to rebuy it again because my son lost my previous one. So literally, I had to rebuy the 13th Doctor's sonic screwdriver. But enough about that anyway. But then you got this one, which was actually Peter Capaldi's actual sonic screwdriver in series 10. And this one is my favourite. I just love the colour of it. I love the blue. I love the silver. And I just love everything about it. So as you can probably see, a little bit, there is a bit of damage on it as well, which is not bad. Like, I've had this for years. This was my third sonic screwdriver. So this was my third one I actually bought myself when I was into Doctor Who a long time ago. And this was my third one. So literally my Doctor Who collection gets bigger and bigger every time. But now, let's find out who made it to number one. And there's a joint number one, because even though I don't have the toy yet for this one, but I will be getting it, and you'll be seeing the video of the toy as well. Let's show you who made it to number one.
Goblin King. It's so good to meet you, you great big thing. I can see you're having a fun day. Meet my friend, she's Ruby Sunday.
It's good to meet you, good to greet you. Good to say how diddly did you. It's my birthday.
Yes, guys, it is David Tennant and also the new Doctor's Sonic Screwdriver. So, guys, I am so proud to announce that basically there is a 15th Dr. Sonic Screwdriver. I do believe the one they show at Toy Fate is the online version, which is more shinier and more cool. Also, this was actually, I will actually be admitted now, this was actually my first one I actually bought when I started getting back into Doctor Who. So literally, I had the two choices between the original and also the online version. But the more reviews I watched on the online version, I kind of wanted the online version. But now, the cool thing is in Argos, they do sell this. They don't sell this version. They sell the normal version that my cousin Gary does have. And you know what? I might even get that one just to do a comparison between the two Sonic Screwdrivers, just to show the other, just to show the viewers on my channel that would it be, how does it look the same? It probably looks the same, but it's probably different colours, shading, everything. And that's what I'm going to do in that video. I'm going to show, I'm going to basically put the, both of them together. I'm going to show you the box difference as well, which is very cool. And you know what, guys? I love it. I've got to do it because it's the noise. I just love it because of that. And the way it comes out. And that's the reason why I like this Sonic Screwdriver. It's my favourite Sonic Screwdriver. I cannot wait for the 15th Doctor Sonic Screwdriver to come out because I will be getting that. 100% I will be getting that. And I really, really do like that screwdriver. I cannot wait for it to come out. Hopefully, we will have a release date for it. But the minute we do, I will be saving a lot of money for it. I will probably be saving money for it. And I hopefully will be getting it very soon. Now, I've just already gave away what the next video is going to be anyway. The next video. So guys, that is the end of my top 10 Sonic Screwdrivers from Doctor Who. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you've liked it. So let's now tell you what is to come. So next to come on the next channel, on this channel, the next video to come up is when I do officially get them. It will be these two. These two. I'm holding like I've already got it. But it will be this and the original version. So I will show you both and I will show you the box difference. I will basically just do a review on this Sonic Screwdriver alone. Then also today, I'm hopefully going to see my mate Mitchell today. I'll hopefully and cross fingers that I'm going to see him today. But Mitchell got me a birthday present and I kind of know already what it is because he has told me what it is already. It is the laser Sonic Screwdriver, so hopefully I will be doing a review on that. So do I dress as the master for that on that day? But to be honest, we will find out in the near future. But right now, guys, in time and relative dimension in space, me and my Sonic Screwdrivers, we're out. We'll see you guys very soon. Enjoy your day. Bye bye.